Hey, what's up, ladies? It's the Relationship Guru, Sid Pharrell. Now, I'm back again with another video just to give you ladies. Now, before I get into this video, please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so that you're notified every single time I post. And if you are a woman that needs relationship advice or want to learn more about how to think like a man or why men do the things they do, act the way they act, and think the way they think, then I encourage you to book a one-on-one session with me. Link is in the description below, and I can help you out personally one-on-one with any questions, concerns, or anything you have regarding your dating life or relationship currently in general. And also, brand new on my website, if you want me to coach you every step of the way, step by step, throughout your dating or relationship process and journey, and you want me to become your personal dating coach long term, then I have a special program just for you. Link is in the description below also, and I can help you out personally again, one-on-one, with any questions, concerns, or anything you have regarding your dating life or relationship currently in general. And also, go pick up my brand new Girls Night card game. It's officially out, so if you're having a game night with your homegirls and you need something to do, then make sure you go pick up my Girls Night card game. We got a lot of fun questions and scenarios about love and relationships and everything all in between, so make sure you go pick that up. Link is in the description below also, okay? And on this hand, we got my brand new ebook. It's called Oh, He's Toxic, Period. And if you never want to be played, used, or manipulated by men ever again in your life, then make sure you pick up that ebook right there because it's fire, okay? And again, link is in the description below also, okay? So all that's out the way, and we're going to jump right into this video. And this video is titled, These Are 5 Signs That He Is In Love With You, Right? 5 Signs That That Man Is In Love With You, Right? So you may ask me, Sid, how do I know when a man is in love with me? What are the signs? What are the ways? Like, what are the clues? How do I identify when a man really cares about me? When do I know when he really loves me? When do I know when he really, really, really is just in love with me and he just can't get enough of me and he just needs me in his life and I just mean so much to him? How does a man express it? Maybe sometimes, you know, you don't catch the signs, or maybe you just want to know specifically and pinpoint, how do men show off and showcase and express their love for a woman other than just telling her that he loves her, or other than just, you know, buying her stuff and just, you know, stuff like that? Like, what other signs can I tell? But how do I know when a man really, really, really is in love with me? How men express their true love for a woman, right? So ladies, coming from a man, coming from a dating coach, I'm going to tell you ladies 5 signs how you can tell if a man is in love with you and you got him wrapped around your finger and he just whipped and he just can't get enough of you. He just like, man, woo. Man, this woman means so much to me. This woman is my world, you know? My whole life changed and man, you just made me just fall in love with you. So here are 5 signs how you can tell if your man, if a man is in love with you, right? 5 signs, all right? So we're going to jump right to the video. We're going to go to number 1. So the first sign how you can tell if a man is madly in love with you is he is consistent, right? So when a man is consistent, that means that he is consistent with everything he does, right? There are no inconsistencies whatsoever. He's going to be consistent within his actions, his words, and his communication overall, right? So let's talk about it real quick. So he's going to be consistent with his actions, right? So when I say he's consistent with his actions, that means everything he does, he's going to continue to do it. He's going to be consistent with all of his actions and all of his moves and the way that he treats you. He's going to be consistent with the way how he acts, the way he treats you, the way he feels about you, the things he does for you. All of that is going to be consistent, the way he feels about you. It's never going to be mixed signals. It's never going to be him, you know, pulling back, pulling away, feeling one way, feeling another way about you. All these, you know, I don't know, I'm unsure about you. No, when a man is sure about you, he know he wants you. And he's going to be consistent to get you and consistent to keep you, right? He's going to be persistent to get you and then consistent to keep you, right? So everything this man does, he's going to continue to do it. If this man started off taking you out every Friday, he's going to continue to take you out every Friday because that's what he started off doing and that's what he's going to continue to do because he's consistent, right? If you're used to this man texting you good morning every morning, he will not miss a day. Or if he does miss a day, it's for a very, very, very good reason. Or maybe he woke up late or something and he was sleeping. He was really, really sleeping or something where he just could not hit you up good morning. But other than that, he will probably usually hit you up and say good morning. So if he says good morning every single morning and you see him saying that, He's going to continue that. He's not going to stop saying good morning out the blue and just stop whatever. He's going to continue to do it, right? He's never going to feel like, oh, no, I don't think this woman is the right one for me. You know, I don't really know about her. No, a man that really wants to be with you, that's really in love with you, he is for sure about you. It ain't no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It ain't no, oh, I don't know about this girl. You know, I don't know. I'm going to get around to her. I'm not ready for a relationship now. I mean, I care about her. It ain't going to be none of that. It ain't going to be no mixed signals. Him calling you one day, him texting you another day. He's not going to go hours and days and weeks without talking to you. He's not going to text you back hours and hours and hours and days later, right? He's going to care. He's going to hit you up right back, or when he gets around to it, you know, if he's busy, right? And then you will be a priority in his life. This man will prioritize you in his life. So that's just his actions. Everything he does and how he feels about you, he's going to be consistent with it. And he's not going to be sending you mixed signals. He's not going to be hitting you up, you know, when he feels like it or when he gets around to it. No, he's going to hit you around when he done whatever, he grinding or he doing his thing. He's going to hit you back, you know, as soon as he get a chance. Like, he's going to hit you back. Like, he's going to make sure he's checking in on you. He's going to be seeing about you. He's just going to care about you and your well-being. You know, when a man really, really is in love with you, he's going to care. He's going to care about your well-being. He's going to be checking up on you, hitting you up. He can't leave you alone. When a man really cares about you, he's not going to be able to leave you alone. He's going to be obsessed with you in a good way. It's going to be like, and not in like a controlling way, like, I want to control her every move and I need to see where she at and see if she's not cheating on me or nothing. No, he just want to see where you at, to see if you safe, to see if you need anything, to see if everything's going all right. He just want to make sure everything's good with you, because he cares and he just wants to make sure you're good. You know, this man's gonna care about you and your well-being, and he's gonna continue to care. You know, it's not gonna be I care one day and I don't care another day. It's not gonna be no inconsistencies. He's going to be consistent with his efforts and his actions and everything like that, right? So now let's talk about his words, right? Now, keep in mind, his actions and his words got to line up, right? So now let's talk about his words, because like I said, his actions and his words need to line up also, and the communication also, right? But we'll get into that in a second. But the words. So you want all the words that he's saying, everything to come out that man's mouth, all the blah, 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 baby, you so this, you so that, I care about you so much, da, da, da. No! I need you to prove it to me. I need you to show me. You can't just be blabbing your mouth and say this. I want to start a family with you. You know, I want kids with you. You know, I want a big house. And, you know, I want to marry you one day. And, you know, whatever, whoop-de-whoop. No! If you really want this to happen, make an effort, right? So he's going to be putting in that effort, and he's going to be consistent with his efforts and consistent with everything he says, right? So if he tells you that I care about you, I want to be with you, whatever, he's going to make it happen, right? Or if he tells you that he's going to do something for you, he's going to do it, right? Let's just say you need a ride to the airport, right? And you was depending on him for a ride. Ain't nobody else answering. He told you, yeah, right? You got to go to the airport. You know, you got to fly somewhere, right? So you ask him, you say, hey, you know, can you take me to the airport, right? He tell you, yeah, in the moment, right? But then later on, the day of, you got your bags ready, packed and ready, and you calling him, and then he not answering, and then when he finally answers, he like, what's up? And you like, hey, look, what you doing? Like, I gotta go to the airport, like, I gotta be there now. And he like, oh, what? Or he just totally forgot, or he just like, man, I'm not trying to take you to the airport, or nah, you know, I never said that, or, you know, nah, I changed my mind, you know, something came up, you know, whatever, whoop-de-whoop, you know, and really, ain't nothing really came up, he just don't feel like doing it, or he just backed away for whatever reason, he just said, what was good in a moment just to make it sound good for you, but then when time came down to it, he really wasn't about it, right? So if he says he's gonna take you to the airport, he's gonna be calling you. Are you ready? He's gonna be waiting on you. You got your bags ready, you got everything you need. You know what time he's gonna be rushing you to the airport. He's gonna be like, are you ready? You know, he's gonna be pulling up, you know, putting your bags in the car. He's gonna be outside ready as soon as you say as soon as it's time for y'all to go to the airport, he gonna be outside ready. It's not gonna be no, I said it, but I'm not gonna pull through for you, right? So you never wanna be in a position or a situation where a man tells you one thing and then he doesn't pull through for you. Those are the worst type of men. And I'm sure a lot of you ladies can agree. Those are the worst type of men. The men that say one thing and they're going to do something for you and they don't pull through for you. Or they not dependable, you know? They're unreliable. You know, they're just men that just be talking. They just say things that sound good, but when it come down to it, they not really about it, right? They just talking, right? Or let's just say, you know, say like you short on a bill and like you ask him or whatever. He's like, oh man, ain't no problem. You know, I'll cover it. You know what I'm saying? I'll give you the bread, whatever. I'll give you the money. And then And then when it come down to it, he don't give you the money. He don't send you the money. Or he be like, oh, I spent the money. Or I ain't got it right now. Or whoop-de-whoop. No, you told me you had it. I'm depending on you because I got to pay this bill real quick. And I don't have the time to be waiting on you to be figuring out what you're trying to do. If you told me at first that you was going to do it, if you told me that you had it, I expect you to have it. If you didn't have it, you should never agree to it, right? So you as a woman, you'll probably be mad. Like, you told me you was going to give me some money to pay this bill. You know, I asked you and you agreed. So then when I look for you and I'm like, okay, I need to pay this bill. And you like, oh, nah, I ain't got it right now. Or nah, you know what? Nah, I changed my mind. I ain't going to give you the money, whatever. You're going to be mad. You're going to be like, why would you even tell me that? I was depending on you. And you said you had it, and I was really trying to pay this bill, but now you tell me one thing, but you don't pull through for me, right? So you're inconsistent. If you're gonna say one thing, you better stand on it. And if you're not gonna do it, then don't say nothing at all, right? If that man is not gonna do it, he needs to know not to say nothing at all. Don't agree to something that you're not gonna do, right? Because when it comes to a woman, you know, they pay attention to all that. Women pay attention to all of that. Women really pay attention to zone in to really how a man treats her and what a man says and how his actions and his words line up. A lot of times women be like, nah, you fake. You was saying all this stuff. You was making it seem like you just had it like that, but you really don't, you know? Well, a lot of times women, you know, they investigate and they see the fake and the phony men. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, that's what it is. So he's going to be consistent with his words. Everything he tells you, he's going to do it, right? The last one is his communication. So he's going to be consistent with his communication. He's not going to let a day go by without him hitting you up or talking to you or anything like that. He just got to be around you. And again, not in a possessive, not in a controlling way, but he just feel like I just got to be around her in a loving, I need her in my life because I can't not live without her because I care about her so much. I'm proud to have her. So it's like he just gonna be calling you, texting you, wanting to see you, wanting to take you out, always wanting to spend time with you. You always like, dang, this man really like me. He always want to spend time with me. This man spent a whole weekend with me. You know, we chilling, we vibing, whatever, whoopty whoop. This man, you know, spends a lot of time with me. He always calling me. He always texting me. You know, he always wants to see me. You know, he reaches out. You know, he makes an effort. You know, he's really pursuing me. He's really chasing after me. He's really trying to get me, right? And again, this is a man that you are reciprocating the effort, right? So this is a man where, you know, when he's calling you, you are allowing him to call you. You know, you're answering. You know, you're talking to him for long periods of time. You're showing interest back. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not just him just chasing you, and you don't want him. It's that he's like pursuing you more rather, and you are allowing him to pursue you, and you're remaining in your feminine energy, and you're just reciprocating the energy that he's giving you back. So if he's coming towards you, and he's pursuing you, you care about him back, and you love him back. You know, I'm sure, because so that means that you want him to pursue you and come to you. You're going to remain in your feminine energy, and you're just going to allow him to just do for you. Allow his masculine energy to just do for you and provide for you and protect you and love you and treat you right. And you just sit back and you just receive all of it that you give back and put back into that man, you know, the same love and affection, you know? So that's just basically you just being available. You just making yourself available, right? So when a man is madly in love with you, you want to make yourself available for him so that he can continue to chase after you. So he can continue to pursue you rather, right? So he can continue to come after you. Because this man just wants to check on you. He wants to see if you ate today, if you're good, do you need anything? How are you feeling today? How was your day? He just wants to check in on you just to see, are you doing all right? You know, he just cannot go a day without talking to you. He just care about you. He always wants to spend time with you. He's spending weekends and weeks and days with you. He letting you stay over his house while he gone, or he letting you stay over his house, you know, for days at a time. And he just wants you by him, you know? A lot of times when a man really, really cares about you, he just wants you up under him. He just wants you by him. He just wants you next to him. You know, and it's not in a controlling way. Like, I don't want nobody else to have you. But it's like, I just want you so bad. So I just want you by me, you know? So that's just what it is. So that's number one. He will be consistent with his actions. He will be consistent with his words. And he will be consistent with his communication and his efforts and how he treats you and how he feels about you, right? All that will be consistent. It won't be inconsistent. And it won't be any mixed signals. No mixed signals. Everything will be green flags. No red flags, all green flags, right? No red flags, all green flags, right? So that's number one. Number two. The second sign how you can tell if any man is falling madly in love with you is he will give you a title, right? Now, when I say he will give you a title, I mean that he will call you something, right? Now, when I say he will call you something, I mean girlfriend, fiance, or wife. Those are the three titles that you need from a man. And if you get three out of three of those titles eventually, you won as a woman, right? You won. Because that man is madly in love with you and he chose you to be his wife. Because he said, out of all the women in the world, out of 100 gazillion women in the world, I chose this one woman to be my wife because I want her and I see something else in her that is different from the rest. And I want to spend the rest of my life with her, right? So he will call you one of those three things. He will call you his girlfriend, fiance, or wife. He's not going to call you his girl. He's not going to call you, oh, this my boo. Oh, this my sneaky link. Oh, this just my little shorty. Or this just my little yeah, yeah. Or this just my old lady. You know, all this stuff. It ain't none of that. Because none of that is an actual title, ladies. Everything I just named, the baby, the boo, the sneaky link, all of those things. Those are not titles. Those are just words. Those are just him just throwing out. Those are just like decoy titles. Those are just like, hey, I'm gonna tell you that you my girl, even though I didn't call you my girlfriend and I didn't say I'm your boyfriend and we're exclusive. I just say you my girl, right? That just means that I mess with you and I'm giving you a fake title. That's what that is. It's a fake title. It's not no real title. If a man call you his girl or his bae or something like that, that's a fake title. That's not no real title. A real title is girlfriend, fiance, wife. We grown. Those are the real titles. Now, I understand, you know, we all got pet names and stuff. We may say, you know, that's my baby. That's my boo. Whoop-de-whoop. But eventually, he got to call you his girlfriend, fiance, and wife. You know, he can call you baby. He can call you boo. He can call you, you know, that's my shorty. That's my girl. However y'all talk, whatever y'all lingo is, that's fine. That ain't the problem. The problem is if it never get to the girlfriend, fiance, wife part, and it only stay in the baby boo situation, right? That's the problem. It ain't the problem that you calling him or he calling you baby boo, you know, snookums, whatever y'all call each other, you know, whatever y'all little pet names are. But the problem comes when you never get to the girlfriend, fiance, and wife position, when it's not a real title. When a man really is in love with you, infatuated with you, and can't get enough of you, and really wants to have you in his life, and wants to make you the number one girl, that's how you know if you're the number one girl. If you're the number one girl, he will give you a title. If you're the one that he wants to be with, if a man is madly in love with you, he gonna make you his girlfriend, fiance, or wife. I feel like if a man make you his wife, especially if you get to the wife position or engaged, if a man propose to you and you become his wife, I feel like that's the ultimate love for a woman. That's the ultimate love. When a man says, I'm finna put down my player card, I'm no longer a player, I don't wanna be a player no more, I just wanna be with one woman for the rest of my life because she everything, she fulfills me and my needs as a man, and I don't need to get that from nowhere else, and I've been searching my whole life for this woman and I finally found her and I need her in my life, and I thank God that I have her in my life every day. When a man thanks God and he's just happy, he's on his knees praying like, thank you God that this woman came into my life and blessed me, man, and that you bless me with her, that's gonna be like when a man gives you a title again, that's him choosing you over the whole world, all the other pretty women, all the other women with big booties, all the other women that got good jobs and good careers and blah blah blah, and it's all they stuff, nice cars, nice careers. It's a whole bunch of great women out there that are good wives, that are good mothers, that are good in bed, that have a lot of great characteristics, that hold down a household. You know, that's overall great women, right? There's a lot of great women out there, but he chose you. He said, oh, they cool, they pretty, yeah, they look nice, yeah, they booty's big, but guess what? I don't care about none of that. You number one, I don't care about none of that. I'm past all that. I'm putting my player card down. I'm putting it down, and I'm settling down, baby. I'm coming home. I don't want these other girls. No more streets for me. I'm out the streets. I'm in the house. Get me out the streets. I'm no longer for the streets. I'm in the house now, and I want you because you made me put down my player card. When you make a man put down his player card, and that man feel like I don't want nobody else but you, That's when you know that man is madly in love with you. That's when you know he in love with you. Because he chose you out of every other girl. Because if you were just a placeholder, or you were just a girl that he was just messing with, if you were just a meantime girl, if you were just a right now girl, the placeholder, right? If you was just that girl, he would never give you a title. It would always be a situationship. It would never get to the girlfriend, fiance, wife position. It would always be just a situationship because he's always looking for something better, right? If that man is always looking for something better and he never gives you a girlfriend, fiance, or wife position, and he always puts you in that situationship that, what are we? I don't know what we are. We just kicking it, whatever. Then he's just using you as a placeholder until he gets what he really wants, right? So right now, you're the woman that he don't want. Right now, you're the woman that he don't really want if he has not made you his girlfriend, fiance, or wife. He don't want you. If it's been 6 months by now, if it's been over 6 months, and even sometimes 6 months is even too long. You know, I say 3 to 6 months, you know, at least 3 to 6 months. But even sometimes 6 months is too long. But even after 6 months, and this man still ain't made you his girlfriend, and y'all be kicking it all the time, every day. You done met his family, he done met your family, and you done gave this man everything, your time, your money, your body, your companionship. You gave this man everything, and you never got to the girlfriend, fiance, or wife position, then you just a placeholder, right? But if a man is madly in love with you, that means that he will be looking for other women to take your spot because you're just a placeholder. You're just a right now girl until I get what I really want. I don't really want you, but you'll do for right now to keep me busy while I go look out for what I really want. So I can get everything I want out of you and pretend and practice with you until I get what I really want, right? So he always thinks that something's better if a man does not choose you to be his girlfriend, fiance, or wife. But if a man does choose you to be his girlfriend, fiance, or wife, that means that he chose you. That means he said, ain't nothing else better out there. That's a man telling you, it ain't nothing else better than you. When a man chooses you and makes you his girlfriend, fiance, or wife, he's basically telling you, it ain't no other woman that's better than you. I can't get no other woman better than you, and you the best woman, the best fit for me, right? Either I can't get no other woman better than you, finer than you, better than you, nicer than you, treat me better than you, that's there for me like you, you know, all these things. I can't get that nowhere else. I gotta come home, baby. I need that, right? So he will give you a title. When a man gives you a title, that's when you know that he really loves you and he's in love with you and he's crazy, madly in love with you because he chose you over all the other women. Ain't nobody else better than my girl. And I chose her to be my girlfriend. I chose her to be my fiance. And I chose her to be my wife because I don't want nothing else. Ain't nothing else better than her. She's not a placeholder. She's not the meantime girl. She's the forever girl. She's not no placeholder. She's not the meantime girl. She's not the right now girl. She's my forever woman. You know what I'm saying? She's somebody I want to be with for the rest of my life. And I don't care. And I'm sacrificing. And I'm cutting off everything else for this woman. And that's how you know a man is really in love with you, because he's going to cut off all the other women. And that's another thing, you know, he gonna cut off every other woman, all his exes, all the little girls that he was messing with and kicking it with, you know, all the little hoochie mamas and all the little Jessie Bells and all the little, you know, freak elite girls, you know what I'm saying? All them girls, all them hoochie mamas, they gotta go because I'm the queen now. You chose me to be your queen, and that's what it's gonna be. So we gotta get rid of these peasants, right? We gotta get rid of these little girls, all these little girls you be messing with, all these little girls, these little fun girls you be kicking it with, they gotta go because the queen is here and we about to build a castle, we about to build an empire, right? We ain't got time for little peasants, you know, and you gonna drop all them girls, you know, every girl you ever slept with, every girl you ever talked to romantically, are attracted to, had anything with, you gonna cut off any of those women, all of those women, and you gonna be with me, right? Because when a man really wants to be with you, he don't care. I'm telling you, ain't nothing else better out there. So he's gonna respect you, and he's not even gonna look for nothing else because he don't care about nothing else, and he's gonna be faithful to you. When a man is faithful to you, that's when you know he's really in love with you. When a man is faithful to you, right? So he's gonna cut off everybody for you. But anyways, that's number two. So number two was he gonna give you a title. He gonna call you something, his girlfriend, fiance, or his wife, right? So number three, the third sign how you can tell if a man is madly crazy in love with you is he protects you and he defends you, right? So when a man protects you and defends you, that is his masculine natural energy that he is transferring over your delicate, soft, and innocent feminine energy, right? He's like, I'm the front line. I'm the man. I'm the front line. You got to get through me to get to my girl. And I'm going to die behind her. You know, whatever. Hey, it don't matter. This is my wife. This is somebody that God chose for me. And I'm going to make sure I protect her with all costs. I don't care what happened. I'm going to throw my life on the line for this woman. You know, anything happen, you know, I'm in front of her like this. You know, I'm in front of her like, what's up? You know, if anything, he's not going to let nothing harm you. Can't nobody harm you and can't nobody say nothing bad about you. He's going to protect you and he's going to defend you, right? So let's talk about protection. This man not going to let no man or no woman or nobody going to be able to put their hands on you or touch you or do anything against you or put you in harm's way because he ain't going to tolerate it. He going to jump in front of anything, anybody. He going to stand up to anybody, no matter who it is, for you because he not going to allow nobody to hurt you, nobody to disrespect you or nobody to put you down or nobody to use and abuse you. He's not going to go for it. He's not going to do it because he cares about you so much that he's basically like, look, I care about her so much that you got to go through me to get to her. And you don't want to go through me because if you go through me, we're going to have a problem. It's going to be a real problem. So you don't want them problems. You don't want no smoke with me. So you better leave my girl alone, right? And it won't be no problems. So again, can't nobody harm you. And then when I say defends you, when a man defends you, can't nobody say nothing bad about you. Can't nobody talk bad about you in his face. Or if he hears something about you, he gonna confront it. You know, he gonna say, who you was talking about my girl? Like, what's up? Like, you got me messed up, you know? Or like if somebody talking stuff about you and he gonna check them. Even if it's his friends, if it's his family, if it's his mama, if it's his grandmama, I don't care. He gonna check them because he gonna be like, no. That is not, you're not going to sit up here and talk about my wife in my face. You're not going to sit up here and talk about my girlfriend in my face, my fiance in my face. I'm not going to have it because you are going to respect her while you with me. That's basically like, he going to take it like, that's basically like you talking bad about me in my face. The same way how I would feel if you talk bad about me in my face, that's the same way how I'm feeling you talking bad about her in my face, right? Because me and her are one and I'm not tolerating it. So mama, grandmama, great-grandmama, cousin, auntie, uncle, niece, nephew, I don't care who it is, friend, homeboy, best friend, it don't matter who it is, you gonna respect my girl, and you gonna respect me, and you gonna respect my decision, and this woman is a part of my life now, and if you cannot deal with that, then you gonna have to be cut off because she make me happy. She the one I gotta lay up with every night. She the one that's gonna cook for me every day. She the one that got my kids. She the one that's gonna make sure I'm good when I'm sick. She the one that's gonna hold down the household when I ain't got nothing. She the one that's gonna always make sure I'm good when I'm down. She the one that's gonna put in when I can't put out. She the one that's gonna make sure I'm okay at all given times. Not you, not y'all. I don't gotta come home to y'all. I don't gotta lay up with y'all every night. I gotta lay up with my girl every night, right? I gotta be with her every night. She got my kids, or she just got my heart in general, and I'm riding with my girl, you know? I'm gonna ride with my woman, you know? It don't matter who it is. Mama, I'm sorry. You don't like my girl, mama? I'm sorry, but guess what? It don't matter what you like. I'm not living with you. You don't, mama, I love you, but guess what? But guess what, mama? I'm a grown man and I can make my own decisions. And you need to respect me as a man and trust that how you raise me, I can make decisions on my own. So if you trust me and you love me and you feel like everything you put into me was a good thing and that you did a great job as a parent, then you should be able to trust me in my decisions. You can't even see that this woman is a great woman for me. That's fine. Whatever. I'm going to ride with my wife, right? I'm going to ride with her because I'm the one that's with her every day, you know? And he's going to defend you because he loves you, right? And he's not going to let nobody talk bad about you. He's not going to let the family, you know, how the family get to talking all stuff about you. You know, oh, well, she come in here thinking that she all that. She come in here thinking that she this or she this or she that. Or I think that she this or I think that she that. You know how they family members be talking stuff about you or the family members don't really like you and stuff. He gonna put an end to that. He gonna say something. He gonna say, when he walk in the room, I bet all y'all shut up about her. When I walk in the room, I bet none of y'all say nothing else about her. Y'all gonna be quiet as soon as I come in the room. Y'all can talk all that stuff behind my back because I can't hear it. But as soon as y'all get in my face, y'all know to respect me and my girl. So I don't care what y'all say behind my back, but don't let me hear it. And don't let my girl hear it, because it will be a problem. And you know what? And even like your homeboys, like, you know, the homeboys, man, you with that girl, man, you chilling with that girl, man. You gonna put the girl over the bros, man. We used to kick it all the time, man. You want to lay up with that girl, man. Why you want to lay up with some little girl, man? And you like, she ain't no little girl. She my wife. Don't be mad because you ain't got no girl and you sitting at home playing video games all day and you ain't got no life. Don't be mad at me. You know, friend, because if you my friend, you going to support me. If you my friend, you going to care about what I care about. And I care about my wife, so you going to care about me. And you going to be like, I accept your wife because I care about you as my friend so much that any person that you bring is an attachment to you. I have to care about them too because I care about you, you know, and I care about your decisions because you my bro, you my dog, you my homie. That means that I respect your girl just like I respect you, you know. Me and your girl ain't gotta be cool or nothing, but I accept her and I respect y'all relationship, right? So I get it that you gonna get around to me when you get around to me. Maybe you can't hang out with me as much. Maybe you can't kick it with me as much because you spending time with your girl. And a real friend, that man homeboy is gonna understand that. If that man homeboy don't understand that, then that man gonna cut the homeboy off. That man gonna be like, no homeboy, you got me messed up because if you getting jealous over my girl and you over here getting envious and mad that I'm chilling with my girl, and because you ain't got no girl, you mad because you ain't laid up with no girl and you bored at home and you lonely and you calling me every day. Nah, don't be mad at me, you know. So that's that. So yeah, he will always pick your side. It don't matter if you right, wrong, whatever. He gonna pick your side, you know? Even if you wrong, he gonna pick your side in the midst of it. He might have to take you home, and when y'all get home on a car ride home, he might be like, yeah, you know you was wrong, right? Yeah, you was really wrong, but I'ma ride with you in front of other people, right? But behind closed doors, I can tell you, you know, hey, you know, hey, you know what I'm saying? You was kinda in the wrong, but I still got your back. But you was kind of in the wrong, for real. You wasn't wrong, but I got your back. But he gonna say it to you behind closed doors. He ain't gonna check you in front of everybody and make you look like a fool. He gonna defend you even in the midst of everything, right? So if anything happened, he gonna defend your honor. He gonna defend your honor, and he's gonna care about you, and he's gonna protect you. He's gonna make sure you always good. Can't nobody say nothing bad about you. He's always gonna choose your side. And he's gonna put you first because you are an extension of him. So if they respect him, they gotta respect you. And if they don't respect you, then he gonna cut off everybody. It don't matter if he got cut off the whole world and be with his wife. Then if that's what he's gonna do, then that's what he gonna do because he really love his wife. And he gotta go to bed with his wife every night. Not none of y'all. I'm not going to bed with none of y'all every night. I gotta sleep with my girl every night. I gotta sleep with her every night. I gotta be and living with her every night. Me and her building something. You know what I'm saying? I, you know, we family. And if we family, y'all should love me and y'all should respect me. But if y'all can't and y'all can't understand that, hey, I gotta do what's best for me. You know what I'm saying? I wish y'all well. So, I mean, it don't matter who it is, friend. It don't matter who it is. Ain't nobody gonna come between y'all because y'all are trying to build an empire. And everybody around you, friends and family included, need to understand that and accept you, right? So that's number three. He will protect and defend you, right? So number four, the fourth sign how you can tell if a man is madly in love and crazy over you and in love with you is, it's not all about sex, right? So ladies, when it's not all about sex, that's how you know that man is madly in love with you, right? When it's not all about sex and y'all can have a decent, intellectual, and deep conversation without it being sexual or any sexual innuendos, then that's how you know that man is madly in love with you. When y'all can talk about aliens and space and, you know, a common interest, where y'all want to be in life, you know, just anything. I don't care what y'all talk about, but it got to be something else outside of sex. It got to be an intellectual conversation, a fun conversation, a happy conversation, some type of deep conversation, whatever y'all talk about, you know, it just need to be entertaining for the both of you two to where you two can feed off of each other, right? And connect and actually have a bond together outside of sex, you know? Because if the relationship or the situationship is all about sex, then a man can never fully be in love with you. If a man is only having sex with you and there's no intellectual conversations outside of that, and all he want is sex from you, he don't really love you. He just love what's in between your legs, right? He don't love you. He just love your kitty cat. It's not you, it's what's attached to you. I don't care about you. I don't care who the woman is. The woman could be anybody. I care about that kitty cat. That's what I care about. That's what I'm in love with. I'm not in love with you. I'm in love with the kitty cat, right? If you can have a regular conversation with this man, if y'all can talk, y'all can laugh, y'all can kick it, y'all can hold each other, y'all can lay together and stuff like that, and it don't even have to be sexual. Y'all can just hold hands. Y'all can be in the car. You know, he could put his hand on your leg while y'all in the car. He could hold your hand. He could be affectionate and kiss on you and, you know, and touch on you and stuff without it being too sexual and stuff like that. Then that's how you know that he really cares about you. I mean, like, if he grab your booty or something, like, he rub on your booty or something like that, I don't really count that as super sexual, because it's like, you know, it ain't super sexual. It ain't super sexual until you know when he really trying to get some, right? When he really trying to push up on you, then whatever. But if y'all just laying in bed, he just give you a booty rub or whatever, and that ain't what I'm talking about. I'm talking about when he really trying to, you know, put it to the side, like, what's up? I'm trying to get up in there, like, hey, you know, hey, I'm trying to, you know, he trying to feel his hand traveling other places and stuff like that. And you gotta be like, hold on, you know, can we just lay here and just chill for once? Can we lay here and watch the whole movie? You know, can y'all watch the whole movie together without it just being about sex? Can y'all talk and lay in bed and just have a great conversation without it just being all the time sexual? Can that woman lay on your chest and can you talk to her and can she tell you stuff and can you tell her stuff and y'all can actually grow together and learn about each other and learn how to love each other and share things about each other and actually vent and actually connect with one another? Like, can y'all do that? You know, that's how you know a man is really, really, really in love with you. When it's not all about sex, like, of course he gonna like sex with you. Of course the sex gonna be great. Of course he's gonna love sex from you. Every man loves sex. Every man is gonna want sex from you, especially if he's in love with you, or whether he's not in love with you, he gonna want sex, period, right? But you don't want it to be the only thing. That's the key. You don't want it to be the only thing. It's okay if a man wants to have sex with you because he's attracted to you, and you know, if a man's attracted to you, of course he wanna have sex with you, right? That's any man. But you don't want it to be the only thing. If he can have sex with you and still have a conversation afterwards, while y'all still laying in bed cuddling after the sex, then that's how you know that he really loves you. But if right after y'all have sex and then y'all get up and then now he hits you with the, so what you about to do? Or, so what's up? So what you doing tomorrow? You know, maybe we can see each other tomorrow. You know, your Uber outside. I just texted, you know, I just got your Uber. You know what I'm saying? You know, what you about to do? You know, you about to do something else later on? Cause you know, you kind of got to go. You know what I'm saying? Like, if a man do something like that and he dismiss you, you know, and tell you got to go right after sex, or he don't want to cuddle with you after sex, or he don't want to chill with you after sex or talk to you after sex, or it don't be no other conversations outside of sex. Like, let's just say, you know, you're talking to him about your day and stuff like that. You're talking to him about something serious or something going on with you. He just like, yeah, whatever, whoop-de-whoop-de-whoop, blah, 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 you know, whatever. He not really all that interested. But then the second you bring up sex on the phone and you say, oh, you know, something sexual, all of a sudden he's like, what, sex? Where, what? Oh, dang, what you wearing? What you got on? What's your favorite position? What's up? Ooh, girl, dang, girl, you like it like this or you like it like that? Like, what's up? You know, when it's all like that and he's not all that excited when he's talking to you about something regular, you know, outside of sex, then that's how you know he's not in love with you. But if he can talk to you about anything in this world outside of sex, you know what I'm saying, and it's not all about sex, and he care about you and your well-being, he just want to be around you, he just want to be up under you, he just want to kiss you and hold you, and he shows you a lot of affection and attention, and he's just all around you and all up in your face and kissing all over you and loving all over you and telling you he loves you and how beautiful you are, and it's not all about sex, then that's how you know that he really cares about you and he really loves you and he's in love with you. Because if it's all about sex, that man can never fully love you. All he loves is what's in between your legs. If if you and that man's relationship is only about sex and y'all can't have no other conversation outside of sex, or y'all don't even talk outside of sex, it's always just a pull up. Hey, what's up? Hey, come through. Hey, pull up. Hey, what's up? Every time he hits you, it's, oh, what's up? Pull up. Oh, what's good? Pull up. And that's all it is just a link and then a bye. And then you go y'all separate ways right after y'all smash. That's no relationship. He's not in love with you. He's just in love with your kitty cat because you're just drive-through kitty cat for him. You know, that's all he wants is just to smash you and that's it, right? So that's number four. It's not all about sex. He could talk to you about anything else outside of sex, whether it's aliens, outer space, Mars, Jupiter. I don't care what you talk about. I don't care if you talk about anything. Just whatever y'all talk about, make sure it's just entertaining. Make sure it's something y'all can bond over, something y'all can share information over, something y'all both share common interest in. And he cares about you and what you say. When a man cares about you and what you say outside of sex, and y'all can actually talk and have a connection outside of sex, then that's how you know he's madly in love with you, right? Because a man can never love you if all the relationship is about sex, right? He can never fully love you, right? So that's number four. So number five, the last one, y'all, number five, almost done. Number five, the last and final and fifth sign how you can tell if any man on this earth is madly crazy in love with you is, and this is the biggest one, ladies, this is the biggest one. That's why I saved it for the last one. And it's because you want him to respect you, right? So ladies, that's number five. You want him to respect you, right? Now ladies, this is a very important sign how you can tell if a man is in love with you. If a man respects you, that means that he is truly in love with you, right? If a man does not respect you, he can never fully be in love with you. I'm gonna say that one more time. If a man does not respect you, he can never fully be in love with you, right? He can love you and not respect you, but he cannot be in love with you and disrespect you, right? But if he's in love with you, he will always respect you and never disrespect you, right? You see, when a man just love you, that means he just care about you, right? I feel like loving somebody and being in love with somebody are two different things, right? Whether you agree, whether you don't agree, some of y'all may agree, some of y'all may not agree. But I believe that loving somebody and being in love with somebody are two separate things. When you love somebody, that just means that I just care about you. That's the emotional part. I care about you. I don't want nothing bad to happen to you. You know, I want what's best for you. You know, I care about you and your well-being. I like you around. I like your presence. I like who you are as a person. You a cool person. I care for you. I love you, right? That's just love. When a man just loves you, that means I care about you, but I can still cheat on you. I care about you, but I can still put my hands on you. I care about you, but I can still lie to you, disrespect you, cheat on you. Whatever I want to do to you, I can still do all these things to you just because I love you, but I don't respect you, right? So I can care about you, but I don't take you seriously, right? I care about you and your well-being. I love you. I care for you, but I'm still selfish. I'm still do what I want to do, and I don't respect you. So I'm still cheat because I'm selfish, and I want what's best for me, and I don't respect you, and I don't respect our relationship, but I still care about you. I still care for you, but I don't respect you, right? You want a man to respect you. When a man is in love with you, that means that it's not only the emotional love, it's the action of love, right? So love is just the emotion. When you're in love with somebody, love becomes an action, right? So when love becomes an action, that means that you are showing this person day in and day out, whether they're in your face or not, how much I love and respect this person. So it don't matter if that man is in a room full of women, he won't even think about cheating on you. It could be beautiful women all around. They could be nice, they could be cool, whatever. And he could look and he could be like, okay, y'all some nice looking women. But he will never, ever, ever be tempted or choose those women over you. Because that man respects you in the relationship so much that even though he cares about you and he loves you with the emotion, the action is him respecting you. And the action is that he will never betray you, never neglect you, never cross you, never disrespect you, never go against you. Because he's with you. He's on your side. And your problems become his problems, and he's never going to hurt you. So not only do he not want anybody else to hurt you, he's not going to hurt you himself. Because a lot of times a man will defend you and protect you, but that's against other people. Because behind closed doors, he's really hurting and abusing and neglecting and mistreating you, right? He's hurting you. He's putting his hands on you. He's lying to you. He's disrespecting you, cheating on you and stuff like that. But then he got the nerve to say, I don't want nobody else. You better not touch my girl. Can't nobody else touch her except for me. Like, what does that mean? Can't nobody else put their hands on my woman, but except for him. He can put his hands on you, right? That don't even make sense, right? That don't even make sense. But to some men, that makes sense. So that goes into the category when a man just loves you. When a man just loves you, I care about you, and I want, and I'm gonna protect you, and I'm gonna defend you, but I don't respect you. So I'm gonna put my hands on you because I don't respect you, right? But if a man is in love with you, that means he respects you. That means it don't matter how mad I get at you, I'm never gonna put my hands on you. It don't matter how mad I get at you, I'm never gonna cheat on you. It don't matter how mad I get at you, I'm never gonna lie to you. I'm never gonna disrespect you. I'm never gonna call you out your name because I respect you. Right? When a man respects you, he would never call you out your name. He would never call you a B word. He would never call you a blank, 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 whatever. He never call you nothing because he loves you, right? And no matter how mad he is, he don't care about the emotion part. He care about the action part. So again, love is an emotion. In love is an action. When you're in love, yes, an action, and you're showing somebody that I love you. So you'll never betray them. You'll never neglect them. You'll never cross them. You'll never switch up. You 100. You the same person I was yesterday, today, and the day after. I'm always going to be the same person. But when that man only loves you, he going to switch up here and there because I care about you, but I only care about you to a certain extent because I care about me more, and I'm going to do what's best for me. But when a man is in love with you, he going to do his best for the both of y'all, or a lot of times he going to put you first before his own needs, right? So that's the difference. So when a man is in love with you, he's not going to disrespect you. He's not going to cuss you out. He's not going to put his hands on you. It ain't going to be no him putting his hands on you. He loves you too much to even think about him putting. It don't even matter if he's mad at you. If he's mad at you, he's going to take a walk. He's going to leave the situation, whatever. You know, he may be frustrated, but he will never put his hands on you. You know what I'm saying? Never, ever, ever put his hands on you, right? And he'll never cheat on you. So it don't matter. So it don't matter what temptation happened, what woman come his way, what woman want to see him, you know, how beautiful the woman is, you know, whatever. No, I'm cutting off and turning down all women. I know I'm an attractive man. I know I got money. I know women find me attractive, whatever, whoop-de-whoop. But at the same time, I'm a one-woman man. I'm a one-woman man. Okay, sister girl, I'm a one-woman man. And I can't be messing with you like that. You know, maybe if I was single, hey, you know, whatever. But I ain't single. I got what I want. And I don't need nothing else. So get back. Get back away. I don't want you in my life disturbing me and my happiness and my peace because I'm happy with what I got. And when a man is happy with what he got and he respects you, he will never cheat on you. He will never disrespect you, never lie to you. He don't got no reason to lie to you. He gonna be upfront and be honest with you all the time. He gonna be 100 with you. He gonna communicate with you. He gonna tell you how he feeling at all times. He don't even want to hurt you. He want to treat you right. He's going to treat you right. He's going to be consistent in treating you right. He's going to be consistent in how he treats you, his efforts. And he's going to go all out his way for you. When a man is madly in love with you, he's going to go out his way for you. You going to be having this man doing things he ain't never, ever, ever done before in his life. He going to be doing so much things for you that he ain't never done. He ain't never took this girl out to this type of restaurant. I ain't never took this girl out to these type of events. I ain't never sent a girl flowers to her job, you know? I ain't never put flowers on her doorstep, you know, so that when she opened up the door in the morning, she see flowers in a card there, you know? I ain't never done that kind of stuff for a woman before, right? I ain't never, you know, made a whole picnic outside in a park before, and I arranged all of the picnic stuff and all the candles and everything. I put all that together, right? I never did that for a woman before. Or I never put rose petals and candles and balloons and money and whatever else. I never decorated a room like this for a woman. I got rose petals all over the ground, candles all over the ground. I got a few $100 bills spread out, you know, for the woman so she can see the money spread out and the rose petals and stuff. You know, we got champagne bottles in the room and stuff, you know. Got chocolate covered strawberries. You know, I got a tub. The tub got rose petals. There's a bubble bath in the tub. You know, I lead her all the way through a maze where she see all the candles and all the rose petals and she see all the balloons and all the whatever. Yeah, I never done this for a woman before. I ain't never gave a woman no ring before. I never proposed to no other woman. If every other woman in my life, I never proposed to, but I proposed to you because I want you to be my wife, right? A man is madly in love with you when he break all the rules for you. When a man break all the rules for you, he gonna do anything for you because he care about you. So it don't matter what he do for you, right? It don't matter what you ask for. It don't matter what you need. He gonna do it for you because he care about you. He gonna do whatever for you because he loves you. If you got a flat tire somewhere, he gonna be, where you at? I'm on the way. You call him, I'm on the way. He picking up first ring. What's up, baby? Hey, I got a flat tire. Where you at right now? I'm on the way. Hey, I gotta go. I'm gonna wait. He on the way. And he gonna change that tire for you because he care about you, right? So when a man is madly in love with you, he's gonna go out his way. He's gonna protect you. He's gonna care about you. He's gonna be consistent with his actions, his words, and his communication. He's going to give you a title, a girlfriend, fiance, or wife. He's going to protect and defend you, and can't nobody hurt you or can't nobody say nothing bad about you. And then it's not all about sex. Y'all can actually have a decent intellectual conversation without it being about sex and your booty. And then the last one is he respects you. And he respects you because you respect yourself, ladies. So when you start respecting yourself and you set boundaries and you say, this is the bar, and you start holding him accountable and you say, this is where you need to reach. And if you cannot reach his bar, then you don't need to be with me because I need a real man. So when you carry yourself like that, that man, he fall in love with you because you're a woman that he can't walk all over. So if a man cannot walk all over you, you have value. And if you have value, that man respects you because you're valuable. And if you're valuable and that man respects you, then that man's madly in love with you because he respects you, and you respect yourself because you're valuable. And you know you're valuable. That's why you respect yourself, and that's why he respects you. Boom! That's the whole video, y'all. Those are 5 signs how you can tell if any man is madly crazy, he going insane over you. He needs you in his life. He can't even see what life is like without you. He need to talk to you every day. He need to be up under you. I need this woman in my life. I need to put a ring on her finger. I'm gonna do whatever for her. If she's sick, I'm gonna be her doctor. If she need anything, I'm gonna be there for her because I love this woman, right? So ladies, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification, and I'm out of here. So to the next video.